We're going to talk about the hologram technology and how it can go from a toy to a life-enhancing tool. This is Moco and my name is Maaike Delver. So, Dennis, you're working on a lot of projects to develop life-enhancing use cases for the HoloLens. Can you give us some examples?
I can. We are working in a lot of different fields. We're working in the medical field, working in the construction field as well. Construction is nice because you can imagine that you can visualize a building before building it. You can actually see it before you do it. Mm-hmm. That's nice. But in the medical field, we can really save lives. We can help surgeons prepare for operations. We can help patients to visualize what they will look like after a surgery. We can help a surgeon to find fractures in bones and things like that, as if they are doing the surgery without having the patient there, which will save hours of operation time, and that way we'll save lives with this kind of thing.
Can you tell us something more about how the technology really works?
The product has been developed for over 10 years now. I mean, there's a lot of technology going on, but basically it's just a bunch of cameras that track where you are. And if they take a picture, if you move your head, they will see a different picture, and then it knows how it goes and where you are. There's also a depth sensor, and that's used to measure the depth of things, so you know where things are in the 3D world. So it knows where the tables are, where the walls are, so you can put things on walls or behind tables, and they are hidden by the table because, well, you can't see through a table. Mm-hmm. Or what you also could do is put things inside a wall and then give the user superpowers so they can see through the wall. Which is a really nice
effect. You can see through a wall.
Yeah, that's the effect that you get. Yeah, you can see some piping going through the wall that we use for building companies as well. So they can see inside the wall and see the pipes there. All virtual, of course, but it will help them find water drains and things like that.
And if somebody enters the room, does the HoloLens see that as well, or?
Well, the HoloLens sees that, but it ignores it until they stand still for about half a second, and then it will take it into account.
And those examples you just mentioned, when will we see it on a big scale?
That's going to be a long time. It's going to be a couple of years. The device just came out last year. It's new. This is the only one of its kind. Other vendors are right now spinning up the production to build these kind of things, but it will take a couple of years.
And why so long?
It's very expensive to build, and we are inventing a complete new way of working with computers. I mean, it's just like mobile phones. The mobile phones first were very sparse, and there weren't that many around. And now everybody got them, but it took about 10 or 15 years. And the same will happen with this one.
And I'm curious about who will buy them, and what is it going to cost?
Yeah, this device is about $3,000. Mm-hmm. Or 3,000 euros, doesn't really matter. Right now, companies buy them for marketing purposes, to see how cool they are. That's what's basically going on. But the large institutions, hospitals, they are buying them as well, and they are starting a project right now as we speak.
Thank you very much for telling us some interesting details about the HoloLens. Hopefully you enjoyed this show, and hopefully we will see you back. If you would like to have more information about new technologies or about the HoloLens, please visit our website mocomoments.com or subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you soon.